now be doing editing today. So what we're gonna is that was great. Just basic, well, etiquette means manners, so
that, the do's and don'ts.
Yes, yeah, there we go. And so got some.
Well, the etiquette sheet that she's looking at was developed for our troop long ago in Member Browns because they've been into this for a while. But on your handouts there that we've prepared for you, our troop website is on a card in here. And y'all can go to the website and look at the Brownie swaps, and that etiquette sheet is on our website.
Also, there's the hashtag.
Shared with a pal.
Exchange the swaps you bring. So say like one that she did for a swimming camp. It was a little baggy, had blue sand in it, and a flip-flop sticker on the outside. Okay, that was a swim camp where they were doing swim instruction. So she carries those with her, but she may wear her swap hat that has her swaps from every camp she's been to or every Girl Scout event she's been to. And they will typically have a little tag on them with maybe a camp name, nickname, no personal information, no home address, no full name. We want to put Sarah Smith, you know, Creepy Lane, Hearst, Texas. It'd be too easy for somebody to find you. If it falls off a hat, we recommend that the girls have generic email address. Someone will swap email addresses at work at camp, but you know, it'll be like SusieScout@yahoo.com or whatever. Something that's real generic, so that if a swap is lost with a tag on it, it would not be easy for someone to track that person down. It's a safety issue.
Yes.
It goes with safety-wise. Mm-hmm. And so they're basically little mementos of a Girl Scout camp or an event or something that has happened with scouting. And they trade them and they collect them. And she has a hat and ribbons and all sorts of stuff all over the house. They make hangers one time to put them on.
They always make them, though.
They always make them.
Okay.
And our true philosophy is a swap shouldn't cost more than 2 to 3 cents a piece.
Okay.
And the thing about this is we go to adult trainings and other councils, and one of the councils we go to, they actually have an award for way too much time on your hands. And that's the ones that have sat and crocheted and knitted. And all this, you know, 200 or 300 swaps. I mean, like, really? But you know, people go out and spend 25, 35 cents a swap. But if you're doing 200 of those for an event, that can get expensive. I mean, because what we have always done is equated it to how many boxes of cookies do you have to sell to pay for this? So if you're paying 50 cents a swap and you're going to an event with 200 people, now you've got to sell 200 boxes of cookies to pay for that.
Right, just to give it away.
Just to give it away. But if you're paying, I don't know, do easy math for me.
A nickel
a swap, then, you know, for that 50 cents you get 10. Mm-hmm. So it's far fewer boxes of cookies. Mm-hmm. sell. So that's how we've kind of raised ours, if you will, is how many boxes of cookies do you have to sell to pay for that? So they get pretty frugal when you say, okay, well, that's a great swap, and that would look fantastic, but you're going to have to sell 500 boxes of cookies to fund that for World Thinking Day. And they're like, no, I don't want to do that. Because you're going to sell those boxes, you're going to take that money, and you're just going to give it right away. They figure out ways to use their funds more wisely when you play it.
You should always trade with a variety of trips. Remember to refuse to swap lightly if you already have one. Please discourage collecting one type of swap, and that can incur feelings. Encourage a wide variety of approach and collection of swaps.
Okay, so what does it mean by refuse to collect a wide variety, not to collect just one kind? What are the different kinds of swaps?
There are bag swaps, which is like
the baggies.
There's also
recycle slots. There are
things that pretty much recycle needs.
Yeah.
I keep adding up your brother's blue jeans.
We have several different kinds today.
Taking old blue jeans and things like that. And old blankets and stuff to repurpose those. So basically what they're saying is don't limit yourself to one thing. Don't say, well, I'm only doing bag swaps.
And always say thank you. You can do that with a little courteous.
What can I say? What?
Say thank you. The Girl Scout is courteous. Always have a few extra swaps on hand for those who don't have it. It is also nice if you use someone's swap who doesn't have it to give in return. That is welcome. That is part of what the Girl Scouting is all about.
Well, you know what? My problem is saying
that. It's not. I'm trying to help friends.
I don't ever, my troop doesn't ever get, well, I'm not going to say ever, but very seldom gets a chance to get with other girls.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so we don't interact with them enough to exchange this one. Do